We want to determine the domain and range of a function given the graph of the function. The domain is a set of all possible x values for the function, and the range is a set of all possible y values for the function. Well, x values are along the horizontal axis, and y values are along the vertical axis. So to help us determine the domain of this function, we want to project this function onto the x-axis, or analyze it to determine how the graph behaves from left to right. So if we were to project this function onto the x-axis, or if we had a bright light up here that was shining down on the function, it would produce a shadow on the x-axis from negative 2 to positive 4. But notice how we have an open point here at x equals negative 2, so it would not include the value of negative 2, so we'll make an open point there. But because this point is closed, it would include positive 4. So the domain of this function would be the interval from negative 2 to positive 4, not including negative 2, but including positive 4. And we can express this a couple ways. Using inequalities, we can say x is greater than negative 2 and less than or equal to 4. Or if we want to express this using interval notation, it would be the interval from negative 2 to positive 4, where it's closed on positive 4, or includes positive 4, so we make a bracket, and it's open on negative 2, so we use a rounded parenthesis here. Now for the range, we want to do the same type of analysis, but now we want to project the function onto the y-axis, or analyze the graph to determine how it behaves vertically. The lowest point on this graph would be right here at y equals 0, and then notice how it would extend all the way up to y equals positive 8. And in this case, it does include 0, and it also includes positive 8, so the range would be the closed interval from 0 to 8. Again, we can express this using inequalities as y is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 8. Or using interval notation, we have the interval from 0 to 8, and it's closed both on 0 and 8 because it would include the endpoints. Now let's take a look at another example. Again, we'll first try to determine the domain, which is the set of all possible x values, and x values are along the horizontal axis. So we want to project this function onto the x-axis, or analyze it to determine how it behaves moving from left to right. The leftmost point on this graph would be right here at x equals negative 2, and then it would include every x value all the way out to positive 2, but notice how we have an open point right here at x equals 2, so it does not include positive 2, so it's an open point here. It does include this point here, so it's closed here. So the domain would be the interval from negative 2 to 2, including negative 2, and not including 2. So we could say x is greater than or equal to negative 2 and less than positive 2. Or using interval notation, we have the interval from negative 2 to 2, closed on negative 2 and open on 2. Now to determine the range, we want to project the function onto the y-axis, or the vertical axis, or analyze the function to see how it behaves vertically. The lowest point on this graph would be right here at y equals negative 4. Notice how it would include negative 4 because this point is closed. And then the graph includes every y value all the way up to positive 4, not including positive 4 again because of this open point. So the range would be the interval from negative 4 to 4, including negative 4, but not including positive 4. So we'd have y is greater than or equal to negative 4 and less than 4, using inequalities, or using interval notation from negative 4 to 4, open on 4 and close on negative 4. Okay, I hope you found these two examples helpful. We'll take a look at two more in the next video.